Hello again, everyone. We are still playing Final Fantasy VII, and it's still a nice game. And the retranslation still adds a whole lot of value to it for me, personally. Now, we are going to be revisiting this City of Ancients. And where we need to go is over here, if I do not remember wrong. It is City of the Ancients, right? No, Forgotten City. Heh. Whatever. I'm not changing the video title. That kicks work. I have to hit the buttons. Okay. You just float off and do your thing. Okay. We'll be having cutscenes now, right? The white materia and stuff. That's what Eris was about to do. This dichotomy between holy and meat here. Of course, they seem to have some fun with this in the Osmak boss design in Final Fantasy IX. Well, super boss, really. Well, we'll see. I don't think I will go and deal with Osmak in the course of my Final Fantasy IX let's play, but all bets are off at this early stage. I still have Final Fantasy VI to get through. Huh. Holy is kind of a strong spell, right? Now, this turn of phrase obviously assumes that the planet does have some kind of consciousness. I believe that is the whole point of the Gaia theory. Well, I mean, I think it is called the Gaia theory in the game, but I think a real world culture, possibly the Greeks, since the Gaia comes from the Greek language, possibly the ancient Greeks believed something like that themselves. I mean, well, in the real world, Greek mythology with Zeus and Zeus, Hera, all those guys. Anyway, I'm out of my war. I'm out of my area of expertise. So let's just get back to Final Fantasy VII. Yeah, there's a question for the books. Are we humans good or bad for the planets? Of course, now here in the real world, there are many who would say that humanity is bad for the planet. A really good and truthful answer to that would, of course, be a little more complicated. So we are not going to go into that. Okay, find the white materia, speak to the planet. If we say our prayer and the white materia glows green. I guess we're good. Except we don't have the white material. Bada bing, that is the thing that bounced off her air piece. Okay, that's it. Game over, guys. Go home. Except we have another disc to play through. Thank you. Like, all the thanks to you, retranslator, for changing this. In the original translation, Bugenhagen just said, "It's all Greek to me." Which really broke immersion for me because, of course, in this world, Greece does not exist. So, saying it's all Greek to me makes no sense. Should not exist. Should not happen. And now it doesn't. Woo! To the music box that we accidentally already collected while looking for something completely different. That is how I roll. Revisit my choice of FMV mod again. Those blocking artifacts. Ugh. Better to use the original videos. But the water looks pretty good though. I'm not sure if we're doing anything to it. Ooh, frame rate. Look at that! The white material is glowing green. So, at least there's hope for the planet. Holy is being summoned. Third disc to play through for a reason. So now we officially resolve to follow through with Eris's ambitions for her storyline, or whatever you want to call it. Yeah. I get a well-earned rebuke from the old-timers. I'm okay with that. Okay, do you have anything else to say, Mr. Dude? Okay, I completely failed to speak to you. Okay. Well, never mind then. Yes? We do remember that. Go on. Oh, yeah. This bit, I love. Just excellent direction. Good music, too. And it looks quite pretty. Well, I say it looks quite pretty, but screw it, you can see for yourself, and I'm sure you will agree with whatever it is I really meant to say. Oh yeah, we are getting to revisit Midgar. Huh. Well, color me surprised. Scarlet actually has, knockers. dignity. We're dignified fans of Final Fantasy VII. Right? Right. Can't quite counteract the game's animation peculiarities. Remember if there's something we can do before going to Midgar. I don't believe there is. And yeah, by the time you're watching this, of course, I will have already proceeded past that point, so No point in reminding me. I will. Oh yeah, that's right. Diamond weapon. It's time for freaking diamond weapon. Okay, well screw that. We're going for that just right now. Yeah. A diamond weapon comes first, then we'll worry about the rest. Well, I mean, is there some kind of pertinent side quest we can go on? Look at that. New model for the new weapon. Well, new world map model. Good. Our computers can handle that now. We're not running into little PlayStations. You know, I'll keep my party set up as it is. Going to check that I have enemy skill on everyone, and then we can go to town. Oh yeah. Kate Sith of Shinra calling Barrett out for his hypocrisy with regards to the sanctity of human life. Speaking of weapon, by the way, I massively hope that I called it Diamond Weapon, which it is really named. It has no other name. If I call it something else, oops. Target. Let's see, that person's down this way, right? Yep. Now, we have Vincent, we have Monarchy. We have a game save to fall back on. Now that we are going to get smashed, I think we're pretty well set for this. Do you have any skills? Do you have any skills? Do you have any skills? Well, that you. Not that Monarchy has a whole lot of any skills on this skill material. We are super pretty! It's fire, ice, and lightning. No, I think we'll keep that. Progression will be continuing the inventory. There we go. Yeah. Okay, is there something else we should talk about? As Master Diamond makes his way towards us. Hey! You don't get to turn like that. Huh, I think actually that's a pretty good turn radius. Okay. Let's go, I guess. Your textures look really strange. Making sense? Oh, you guys like me? Good to know. Ouch! Ouch, ouch, ouch! Anyway, let's go for some big damage. Okay, 2,000 something. 3,000? Okay, Thundaga hits harder than freaking Bahamut. Okay. Not complaining. Just struggle pronouncing that name, you know? And Alexander just destroys my friend. Whoa! No? Don't you freaking dare. Not counting down on me. Oh, right, I'm just gonna do that instead. Oh, piss. I'm just going to just before Vincent now, aren't you? Ha! Vincent lives! Son of a dog. Okay, so that's a countdown to that attack only. Well, that's alright then. That is, not that's alright. Okay, I fire them to attack, apparently. Since the monkey does not get hurt by it. Because freaking Vincent has it and he's just doing his thing. Well, shit. Rod on me. Oh, and now you're immune to physical damage. You get the knife into the face again. Okay, well, that could have gone better. I will admit that. But I get many levels, I get quite a bit of AP as well. That's all good. Ooh, ooh, wow, plenty of money too. Okay, let's go. Lovely. It was very much to my geek senses, this bit. Geek sensibilities, I mean.
hard. Or selling. Lasers, I'll just fire my laser projectiles. Well, snap. Right through that, well, also send it flying. That cannon packs a bit of a punch. It also melted part of the mountainside. That's that is attention to detail that you didn't often see in games of this era. That, my friends, is Rip Rufus, and I don't care about Advent Children. Are we clear on that? Yeah, Northern Crater. Hey, wait. Isn't that... Okay, I just, yeah, okay, let's just see what's up with this first. I didn't master any materials, right? I just got a whole bunch of AP for them. Looking like I might, level up Bahamut before the end of the game, so that's all good. Level Bahamut up to 2 is what I mean to say. Okay, well, let's see if we can find a spot to save so I can end the episode. It's been a pretty long one. Okay, I'll save it here. We're in the episode, and we'll see about revisiting Midgar probably at some point in the next episode, but yeah, who knows what'll happen, right?